Right, okay, today we've got a boxed, no manual, squashed Pokemon Diamond. So let's get that scruffy box out of the way and let's have a look at this. Now, looks okay from there. It's not until you get to here that you realise that's pretty much mullered and the back's cracked. So the back can just come off. Hopefully, carefully, because I want to try and preserve the front of it. If I can, without ripping my fingernails to shreds. Need to find a better nail. That's the one. These things were not designed to come apart. But a part is something that needs to happen. Right. Well, that looks like water damage. They look pretty manky. Looks like it's been soldered. Let's give it a clean up. I mean, I probably should have tried putting it in a Game Boy first, but I'm going to take the seller's word that it didn't work. So, first things first, let's get a copy of Big Brain Academy and try and get that open. I mean, I've left part of my fingernail in it. Boards out. Put this one in. Just clean them up a touch, but in there. I've got a Mankey DS light here, so let's pop that up. Let's put this in, see what it does. It does nothing. Just make sure this DS does play a game. It does. So let's try this Pokemon in a random shell again. Pokemon Diamond. Data could not be read. Please turn off the power and read. Okay. But it does something, if not what it needs to do. Well, let's get it out of its new home. Where's the brass brush? That's a lot cleaner and shinier. So we'll try that again. Got to fit it just over these two little things here. I wonder if that'll work without the front one. It could not be read. Okay. So that looks iffy, but not terrible. That could be a problem. That scratch. That one there looks iffy. And if we flip it over, contacts aren't great, but they're not terrible. I'm going to try a little bit of flux. Around So that side should be okay. Currently bubbling along at like 319 degrees. Just checking in with the magnifying glass to see what they look like. They don't look superb, so I might give them a touch up with the old supersized tip off the mat, off the once the temperature comes back up. Right, let's get zoomed out. That's still exceptionally hot, but hey ho, I'm going to pop it in here with the big brain cover. Data could not be read. Please turn off the power, then remove and reinsert the DS game card. Okay, well, back to the drawing board then. Or should I say, back to the heating board, because... Can I get the hot air out? Gonna have this little nipper off the side. goes that way. Now, it's going straight in. Data could not be read. Okay. So that's not the issue either. Well, there's only one thing for it. Chip comes off, and I will put it this way. I'm imagining there's a broken trace or something on that circuit board, but CO110 is what we have out of brain training. CO310 is what is on Pokemon, so, oh sorry, Big Brain Academy, CO501, that's no good. I'm gonna have to go and look through some old crappy DS cartridges and see if I can find CO310. I'll be back shortly. Right, I think the original brain training is a CO310, excellent. So that which I'm being a little less careful with, although it's come off all right, should make a nice replacement for this. Don't know if this chip is going to be the same, but I'll just try and replace the mask room to start with. And let's see what happens. tin up these pads a bit. That looks a bit nicer. Try and line it up as best I can beforehand. That's not very good. That's nearly there. So let's get some heat all over it. One side looks great, the other side looks wonky. But they are connected, so let's see what it does. Burns my fingers, that's what it does. Welcome to the 1UP Gaming channel, where every couple of days you see me burn my fingers on something hot. Do I try and change that over. Or do we just try and see if this will start again? No info needed. Just want to skip through this bit. Barry, you mean Barry? What is this? I hope it's not blood. You are almost a Jill sandwich.
Yeah, enough of my crappy Resident Evil quotes.
Just want to start a game and see if it saves. Yep, saving a lot of data. Don't turn the power off. Well, apparently the game is saved. Let's find out. Well, there we have it. Replace the motherboard and you solve the problem. Although the next problem is how to get this to stay on here. Because obviously the original one was completely battered. And this is just being held together by a sticker. What's this other one like? That fits pretty nicely. So I'm going to get the super glue out. Give it a bit of super glue. And then leave it sat under something for a half hour or so, just so it goes off. I have no idea what that noise was. See if it still works. Happy days. All we need now is just to check the save file is still there. Excellent, still there. Loads up and we're sorted. One Pokemon Diamond repaired and saved from the eBay scrap heap. And although you can see the crack on the front, it's not terrible, but unfortunately it's there. But we've saved an original Pokemon Diamond from the bin. Cool, thanks for watching, catch you in the next one.